Welcome, welcome everyone to Chessmas TV, episode 225. Today is March 15th. We missed Pi Day. I love 3.14 Pi Day, which was yesterday. March 14th was 314. Of course, it's not 314 for everyone because for some people it's 143, which is not quite the same. I'm reading a message here. What time does Wiz Cup 4 start? Great question. Yeah. Let's play some Stupid Atomic today. That's the name of the episode. It's named that for a reason. It's not, you might think, let's play some Atomic Chess. Let's put a challenge out there. It's not because Atomic Chess is stupid. Although that is true. That's, of course, not the reason that I would name the episode that, because that's a little insulting to everyone who thinks it's not stupid. Instead, I'm naming it that because I intend to play stupidly for the Atomic Chess today. I'm not going to use the traditional opening of Knight F3, E3, and instant win. Instead, I'm going to play something a little stupider. Now, Atomic Chess is not a very fluid and friendly game. You may not have heard of it before, but let me just describe briefly how it works. When you capture, it's just like a chess game, but when you capture a piece, everything blows up. Your capturing piece blows up, the captured piece blows up. Everything a king's move away around that piece also explodes, unless it's a pawn. Pawns are somewhat sturdier, and that's because they're made out of pawn steel, which helps them withstand the explosion. My challenge is being ignored, but there's this other challenge, so I'm gonna just go for that one so that we can get a game. Hi, Haver. Warn him. I'll warn him that there's a whole bunch of people watching him on YouTube right now. Good luck. Okay, so 9a3, that's pretty stupid. Let's play that. There's super no time. There's no time right now. Cool story, bro. So I have to play pretty fast, but yeah, I'm constantly out of time. Oh, you're out of time, man. So that's not very much time. I was hoping to play like an atomic game where you think about your moves, but as you can see here, if his queen captures this pawn, my king blows up, so I have to block that off. Here, if he captures this pawn again, my king blows up, so I block that off. Here, now he's going to capture this pawn and blow me up, and then here he blows up my bishop and queen. I should have played bishop e3 at this point, because then if he captures this pawn, it only takes out my queen because my bishop has escaped somewhat, so I think that would have been an improvement. Let's take a look at my fan mail here. Hello, ChessWiz. I was just wondering, at what time does Wiz Cup 4 start? I know it's next Saturday. Wrong. It's next. That's so ambiguous. March 26th, not March. So it's the 15th right now to me, because I'm here in this time area of the universe. It starts at 3 p.m. GMT. So that's a little bit difficult to tell, actually, because if you go to the tournament section and you find Wiz Cup 4, which, by the way, has some epic prizes. Thank you to, where's Chess Wiz Cup 4 right there? Thank you to Das Kaninchen, which means the rabbit in German, for sponsoring the tournament. And then you can't see exactly what time of day it starts. It just says in 11 days, so that's a little bit. At what time does it start? 3 p.m. GMT. It's a little bit funny that the sponsor of the tournament is also the number one seed. I find that to be humorous. Let's play more Atomic Chess. Oh, look, there's the challenge out there for 0+1 again. Let's see if I can play some Stupid Atomic a little bit faster this time. So we're gonna go d5. He's trying to just play really quickly, so we'll see how this goes. I don't think he's gonna like this. He loses his queen. I'll just blow up my things here. Put that in there for a nice, your deadliness. Whoa, that was close. I have a queen, so this will come in handy. Boom! Yeah, so that was quite a startling and unexpected, to me, ending for him, but he's completely dead. If he blocks with knight, I just take it and blow up his king. If he moves, then queen e2, blowing him up quite soon. Here, then like here, and then here, and here. Blow him up, because anything I take something, anytime I take something, it goes, and he can't take me, because it blows himself up, so it's quite deadly. Here's the same opponent again. I really wanted to play slower atomic, but this is all we get. So what's a stupid move? Looks like b4 would be pretty stupid. So let's play some stupid atomic today. He's probably confused at my stupidity, but that's what we're going for. Yes, this move now. I take that. Oh, I gotta be fast. That was stupid on his part as well. Oh. This might hurt. Oh, it doesn't hurt. That's too bad. Let's get the queen going here. Seems like I could do some damage here. Whoa! For a moment there, you lose. For a moment there, I moved all of my pieces into a deadly grave of piecedom right here. He can actually take this queen, which blows up my own knight, and his king as well. It survives the explosion. So this is a stupid move. But I was thinking about this move, which blows up my own queen as well. So a much better move here would have been anything else. Like, for example, this move, double check, would certainly destroy him in a rapid manner. Oh, this time control is simply too slow. Let's go back to my time control, which is 1 plus 4, so we can think about the moves before we blunder. There's some cool anti-chesses up here. It's too bad that my episode isn't named Stupid Anti-Chess. That would be pretty fun. What else do we have here? I kind of like this new grid view, and the reason is that the regular view, if you go back to list, it puts the variant stuff in the second half or the lower half now, and so when there's a lot of people playing that popular kind of chess called chess, then the variants sometimes get pushed off the list. And I kind of like chess variants. As you might notice, a lot of my episodes are variant-oriented. Guys, have you seen the schedule coming up? I filled out the rest of the month, by the way. This is the website at chesswiz.tv. You can see the URL right there. If you click schedule, you can see what's coming. And this is all filled out. So this no piece twice is going to be a very interesting variant where you can't move a piece twice. That should be interesting. Okay, so we got a real chess game here. By that I mean an atomic. Then, whoops, that's not the tab I meant. Then we're playing in the bullet arena. This is a tournament, 1 minute tournament. Hoardable chess is going to be some horror chess. Must jump is going to be another interesting variant. And then we've got Chessbiz Cup 4, which is going to be an epic tournament. So don't miss those things that I've just said, because they're excellent. And you can at any time go to that page and see what's coming next, so that should be good. Knight f4. So now I have some time to think. I've got a 4 second increment. How do I just, like, checkmate him here? If I take his king, then I win. Queen here. This seems like... Oh, this isn't going to work because of f3. I didn't even think about f3, which is... like failure on my part. Let's sort of throw the bishop out here. I don't like the lines where his knight takes right here, so at least let's get the bishop out of the blast radius. I'll play this anyway. I like him having to play f3 so that his queen doesn't come out and scare me. So I'll force the f3, and then I need to move somewhere not deadly, so I can't move here. Can't move here, because this would blow up my queen. That's not an arrow, that's an explosion right there. I've received a suggestion in the chat. Someone watching says I should go to Budapest for a hairdresser. I cannot disagree with that statement. This is strange. I mean, it's true that I can't take the knight, but that's no problem. The only thing you can take is the rook, which kind of puts you out of the game. Meanwhile, boy, this is a weird knight. It's a weird knight. Let's go this way. Let's actually go here. I don't usually play knight f6 because of this move. I'm not liking that move very much. Nice. Oh, what's gonna happen? Everything blows up, so what's gonna happen? As usual. Let's play that. I'm not happy with this outcome. Smart play by my opponent. Let's open this up a little bit. Yeah, ooh. Pull this back. Oh, he's gonna take this and blow that up. Not good. Oh man. I have to go here. Which is not good, putting pieces near my own king. Oh, this atomic chess is tough. That pawn is gonna come down, there's no doubt about it. It's gonna cause me some pain. No, I have to lose. He can now take this and blow up everything. But it's my only chance. My only chance is to lose in one move. Shows how bad my position was. I saw this pawn coming down. There's just not a lot I could do about it because it opens up this file if I take, and then the rook checkmates me. And that was basically the outcome of that game. Oh, he's left me. That's good. Let's play you right now. I'm ready. Let's play. Apparently I'm challenging my opponent. That's weird because I really felt like I was taking a challenge. All right, let's play some more atomic chess. Let's play smarter this time. That was an interesting opening. What went wrong? Let's take a look at that game by duplicating the tab and using the back arrow a few times to go back to this game. Not this one though. Forward. Forward here. Nope. Back from that. Here. So let's take a look at this opening. The knight f4. Okay, so I think that queen h4 was a mistake. I had thought that I could come in here and force getting in, but I didn't even see the obvious f3, so that kind of set me back a bit. This knight was obnoxious. There's nothing I can do. I think knight c6 is a mistake. I said, oh, I probably shouldn't do this because of bishop e5, and then I did it, and then bishop e5. So that was quite a sad ending. The problem is this is a very powerful pin in atomic chess. The knight can't move anywhere, as we saw in the game, because the bishop takes this pawn, which blows up my king. So that's pretty painful. Here's our next game against Bahai. Let's play some stupid atomic. I think b4 is a pretty stupid move, but I do kind of like it because a lot of black's attacks, a lot of attacks kind of come down on these two squares for the knights and bishops. So this gives me kind of a head start on blocking those attacks. Oh, this is stupid. This is extra stupid because now if I bring my knight out, he takes it, blowing up my knight. If I bring my bishop out, he takes it, blowing up my bishop. So there's really no good way to follow up on this side of the board now that I've played before. So that was pretty stupid. Congratulations, Chess Wiz. What if I push it again? Oh, let's play here first. I don't want enemy pieces to come down. Whoa, this is kind of exciting. Nice play. Oh boy, so this is going to be hard to deal with here, the knight coming to this square, because I've given up my f pawn, which is a critical defender against my king, and I think I'm okay here though. Come on, let's see your move. Yeah, this is b4 was a stupid opening for sure. Someone hears babies in the background. That's probably your babies. Okay, my king is hosed. But I can kind of use these files to my advantage, perhaps, if I put my rook here. I'm saying, well, my game is ruined, so why not ruin your game as well? Right now, his king is quite well protected by all of these pawns, so if I just kind of take them, maybe I can ruin the position quickly for him. I'm going to give up that bishop, of course. Is tough. Yeah, I'm gonna sacrifice on that. Crazy. Yeah, let's open this file. Hello, fungus chess. It really sounds like a horrible insult, but I mean that in the best possible way. Fungus chess? Hello, how are you? So this is actually working pretty well, opening up these lines. I don't feel like this was a much better outcome than I deserved. And when I was playing e4, e5, he could have just moved his knight out earlier. I feel like if he had brought his knight down to g4, it would have caused me some pain and I would have ended up trading off my good pieces and having nothing left. But here with this open file, I think I've created a kind of problem for him. We're gonna see. Fungus Chess sends me a piece of dung, so that's very fitting for his name. Here, I will just take that. Because of the checkmate coming. Otherwise, I wouldn't want to, because I did lose like everything on the entire board. But this pre-move checkmate, I love the hands-free checkmate, bam! Now, of course, he resigned, so that wasn't as cool. But, you know, I really think he had the advantage around this position right here, but somehow I was able to conjure up some trouble with these open files. He probably could have won that game with better play, and I think it would have involved bringing out his knight and bishop that were in that area quickly. E3, E6, let's see if I can survive this. Very difficult to play atomic chess with black. You're always on the defensive. Can't really afford to play a stupid opening, as they say, because of the pressure that white puts on you immediately. I was looking actually at if G6, then knight takes, no, the knight here. Let's throw this in. And then I'll try this. I'm going to try to survive this way. It's probably a mistake. It's probably some obvious counterattack he has. But let's see if I can survive this way. G6 and then knight here is what I was thinking about, and then if I take him, then his has queen here attacking this pawn, and it's very difficult to not lose a ton of material in that line. So that was why I didn't go with the G6 immediately. I went with D5. That was the reasoning there. So this looks like a fairly good attack. We'll come in here. Maybe he won't reply the way I'm hoping, though. Fungus Chess is back. He says, do you remember like a year ago when I played you and you said, fungus followed me. That was a good memory. I forgot that good memory. I'll send him a frown, but I'll send him a kissing frown. Like, I'm kissing you with my weird clown nose, and I'm sad. So at least there's some meaning to that face. Not that it has any reasonable meaning, but it has some meaning. I love answering fan mail on the stream. I think that's a pretty good way to keep people involved. Don't you think? How do I get in now? There's one open file here, but it doesn't get me into his house. What's the score right now? I'm down an entire piece, so I definitely need to be a little bit smart about what remains. Got problems with bishop coming in right here, so that's why I played a6. I think his best move there was bishop b5. If I take him, then it blows up my own bishop, and if I don't take him, then I lose pretty hard. Let's go here. Maybe here was better. Okay, there's an open file on this side of the board, and I can get my king, my rook over there with king g7, and I think that's safe, although these pawns are very important, very, very important to keep in place before I die. I am behind. Ooh, woo, woo, woo. I'm behind a knight for a pawn, which is not very much behind, actually. The pawn could end up being more useful. I think I can survive this way? Let's find out. No, I can't survive. There's a checkmate after all. You've got to keep your pawns away from your king because they'll blow up in your face and blow up your king. And that's exactly what's happening here. No matter which way I go, he comes underneath and blows up the pawn. And so I had to have my pawns in front of my king in this game, however, because the bishop just had this awesome slice. And if I ever moved the pawn, it would take on f7, checkmating me. So that was definitely bad. I was forced into what I didn't want, and that's why I lost. Taking that pawn with a rook was where I felt like I had the game again, because I was winning a pawn and rook for just a pawn. That was a gain of a pawn, but it didn't go well from there. What would be stupid atomic right now? I think d4, d5, d6 and take that pawn would be good. There's a question in chat. How do I get a chess whiz shirt? People ask me that a lot because my shirt is so handsome, as opposed to me. They don't say, how can I get a chess whiz, right? But unfortunately, you can't. This is the only chess whiz shirt in the universe, as far as I know. I haven't checked everywhere, but I've checked many places, and I don't think you can get one. And if I sold this one to you, then I would have to stream shirtless, which there are certain downsides to that. So I'm not going to be doing that, hopefully. I think I just want a queen, so I need to play smartly. And I should be able to win. What moves are the smartest? Knight a3. This is so not chess. Imagine if this were a chess position. I'm like, oh yes, I move my knights to the crazy corners. That's the strength of the position for sure. But it's true. That's the way you should do it. Atomic is way too dangerous. F3 is such a bad move in chess because it opens up this diagonal. It just generally weakens your king side, also opens this diagonal for after you've castled. But in Atomic, with everything exploding, F3 is an important move for keeping the enemy knight from just coming up and blowing up your face in one move. This is an interesting position. I, of course, have just checkmate here, but he's going to throw his knight in here, I'm thinking so. If I played queen e2, he would have knight e3, which is a shocking response. But this is just terrible for him now at this point. He's so dead. Simply because of my like move 2 when I took his queen for free. Yeah, that definitely set him back. From there, he was not having much of a chance. He castles. I think castling is best. I'll take this. Allowing bishop e3 to protect. Taking the rook is nice, queen for rook, you know, whatever, because I'm way ahead, but I actually like this move forcing him to take it. That gives me the extra move, and then here, threatening to win a pawn because that blows up his knight. So this is going to work well. I'm totally ignoring your comment that requests to see me shirtless. It's not an appropriate comment, so I have to ignore that promptly. I think castling this way is safer. His best move, I think, is check, king over, bishop here, threatening to blow this up. Then I have to play h3, and then he just leaves his bishop there. It's kind of a cool sequence. But now with checkmates coming, I think he's dead. I think he's pretty dead. So now I'll just win that pawn. I have enough rooks to keep any shenanigans away. It's important for me to get these pawns away from my king because, like we saw in the last game, if you're too close to pawns, you can just blow up, which doesn't take long in atomic chess. For those of you just tuning in, this is not chess. You can probably tell. When you capture a piece or a pawn, your capturing piece also explodes, and so you can't really take anything without dying as well. In addition, everything a king's move away, like this, goes off the board as well, unless it's a pawn, because pawns, like I mentioned, are made of pawn steel. So everything, oh, isn't that a cool shape? I think so too. I'm going to leave that on the board. It's so nice looking. Wow. Okay. Check. Oh, I'm a stupid face. Why did I fall for that stupid thing? I'm so stupid. Well, at least it fits the title of the episode, Stupid Atomic. If I just moved this pawn, I would have been fine. That was stupid. That was really stupid. Oh, well. Oh, well. I've nearly forgotten it. And in a few more years, I will completely have no recollection of that stupidity. So I think I can probably survive that long. I think h6 will work here. We got an an LOL in the chat. Maybe I should blunder more because that really helps get audience participation up. Just blow up my own king, and then people are like, oh, oh, oh. I'm going to type, hello, Bailey J. Stalker. I think your last name is pretty fitting. That would be Stalker in this case. And I think that well describes you. D5, I guess. So you're going to play here, which I find extremely annoying. I'm not sure if this is good for me. I feel like it's bad, but at least I'm not getting destroyed. Being a black player is very difficult in Atomic, so this is as good as it gets. Let's play that. Oh, he could play here still. So let's play. Oh. Let's open things up. I'm the one, it's my turn right now, except it's not, right? But I'm the one opening things up, which means perhaps I'll get the initiative from such a play. If he takes, he loses his knight. Here, I think maybe I want to take with the bishop. Yeah, I'll go for the extra piece. The bishop does have a lot of mobility, so this could be good. I have queen here at any time. And then queen here? I don't know. Some cool moves. I'm not sure where I should go with that queen. This is going to be a race of deadly pawns. He cannot take, of course. The queen blows up his king. So I'm going to push this pawn into his throat to see how he likes choking on this. Should be interesting. Sejorent J asks why all Americans have such huge cans to drink from. And I think that's a great question. I'm an American, so perhaps I can answer that. But first, I want you to tell me why you picked that name, unless that's actually your name, Sejorent J, in which case, I'm sorry. This is problematic. Let's get the queen alive first. Oh no, he could take this. My plan was to go here, but he would just blow up all my valuable pieces at once. Yeah, in that case. This is looking pretty good now. I can also take this at any time. It's like a small drone in Dutch. Okay, now you've answered the question. Now I will tell you why we have such drinks. Uh-oh. What was I thinking? Does this work? He's coming in for me, and I need to not die. And so queen d8 would have killed me pretty bad, so this is my move. King f8, very strong, and don't know how to survive, but perhaps I could throw this in, or, you know, bishop g5, g4, something, just to survive. I'm dead, I'm dying, I'm dead also. Oh, I'm out of time, but this was going to work. It was totally going to work. No, and then he'd play here. Yeah, I was dead. The reason that we have such large drinks is because we're fat and lazy. Fat and lazy. That's why we have such large drinks, soft drinks usually, which are full of sugar. So let's play this new bad, stupid opening. Queen d6. That wouldn't have worked. Wouldn't have worked very well. Bishop could take it. And after this move, then it would die to queen f7. So if it is an idea anyway. So that's the reason we have such large drinks. Those two reasons, fat and lazy. So now you know. How do I kill this guy? I think I can actually kill him like this. Now, you might say just because you're fat doesn't mean you should drink large drinks, but there is a strong correlation because when you're fat, you're addicted to being fat, and it's not your own fault because addictions are hard to break. So it's only partly your fault, but that is actually the reason. Soft drinks are addictive, in my opinion. I once knew a man who drank an extreme quantity of them every day, and my conclusion was that he was under a form of addiction. So I stay away from soft drinks. Actually, I haven't had a soft drink in a long time. Last time I had a soft drink, it was on the way up, if you know what I mean. Why are you here, baby? That's weird. Is that your baby? He has a queen and I don't, so this is a little dangerous. If knight here, then I'm going to play my knight up. I do hear that. That's very strange. I'm not hallucinating. D4 is going to save me here. I don't really mind losing a piece for a pawn because my pawns are so important in this game. That's like a pawn is worth a piece to me, you know? I think that move is more important because if he plays queen a5 and then queen a6 coming in this way, I need this pawn here to survive. Let's play it this way. Open files are great. It is a great microphone. And Jovis says, that must be a great microphone because we hear babies. Yes, look at this microphone. It's shaped like something I won't even say. This is an epic microphone. It's called the Blue Yeti. I've purchased it specifically for recording things, if you can believe it. And I like it. It picks up a lot of bass tones, which is a problem because when I do this on my keyboard, then people who have no bass in their speakers are like, oh, nothing's going on, I'm fine. But people who have bass in their speakers are like, it sounds like construction zone occurring inside the microphone. It's pretty bad. So very sensitive microphone. I like that because I'm a sensitive person when it comes to my own feelings. Let's blow up the bishop. Somebody set up us the bomb. Am I going to survive? Somehow I feel like I won't. Okay, I'll take that. Now I'm ahead two items. And not thinking like two amazing pieces, they are only pawns. However, if I castle, I'm gonna be next to all of this deadly stuff. This is so scary. There's an increment, so I'm okay here. My goal is to lose a pawn while training knights. And then I'll be ahead one pawn and I'll win. Let's get these pawns away. I could actually lose a knight for a pawn here and be okay, just because two items is so much better than three. So I'm gonna try to lose a pawn here, and then I'll be ahead one pawn if I counted correctly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 against five. Yes, so that's my plan. Be down a pawn, ahead a pawn. And that'll work just as well as being up a piece. In fact, better, because I've never been able to promote a knight. The more I move it to the back rank, the more it just sits there and looks dumb. So my strat here is to move a pawn to the back rank, which is pretty cool. It's like a cheat code, and it improves your pawn vastly. Bam. Yeah, you have problems now. He actually was smart to give himself two pawns in this area, because then he could cause a little more trouble, but I promoted first, so I guess that wasn't very smart, because getting the opponent to have an extra queen is not a great strategy. Like, what should I do right now? Maybe I'll, extra queen for my opponent. That's my strat. Let's see if I can do it. Yes, I achieved my goal. My opponent has an extra queen. Now I lose. Yeah, that's kind of what happened. Oh no, the episode is over. I should abort this. Sorry, we went over. So I was having so much fun blowing things up that that's actually, I'm on a time constraint right now because I have a job. So lucky you guys who all you have to do is go to school. I actually like jobs more than school. Sorry, did I say that backwards? Yeah, I like school better because there's a little bit of variety. I mean, you can sit and be bored in front of one class and then go to another class and be bored over there. Totally different classroom. I mean, that's totally different, right? But at a job, you're like in the same, doing the same thing all the time. So yeah, so you people who are in school, you should consider yourselves lucky, because when you grow up, you'll be even border. I'm just kidding, of course. I actually like my job, and border isn't a word the way you think it is. This has been Chess with TV. Thanks for watching.